Hello, Namaste and welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Mansha. I am a tarot card reader, numerologist, vastu consultant and crystal consultant. If you have any queries regarding any of these, you can just DM me on Instagram or you can contact me on the number provided in the description box below. As you already know from the description that this video is going to be about how is 2022 going to be for all the zodiac signs. And in the first part, I have already mentioned that I am going to be taking the sun signs, that is the sign according to your date of birth. We were done till the Virgo sign. Now we are moving forward with the Librans. This is the seventh sign of the zodiacs, Libra. Okay, let's check how is 2022 going to be for Librans out there. I am seeing a pattern that this year all the Librans are going to take their decisions a little bit immaturely and it is not going to be very practically. Okay, I am seeing a pattern over here that all of the Librans are going to take their decisions a little bit immaturely and less practically. There is going to be a lot of hard work necessary and also a lot of emotional investment. And also I am seeing that people who are Librans might get married this year. This is the year of marriage. This is the year of involvement into relationships or commitments. And also people need to be a little bit careful regarding the workplace. There might be betrayal at the workplace and there might be commitment in their personal lives. This year it is going to be a little bit up and down professionally because I am seeing a lot of dominance from the work end. This year they might have to put a lot of efforts, as I mentioned earlier as well. This is going to be the year of hard work. So if they will put efforts in their personal life and professional life, they will achieve success in both the fields. So overall this year is going to be mix and match of both the things. Some things are going to be good personally, some things are going to be good in professional life. Okay, now it's the turn for Scorpios. This year, 2022, is going to be the year of possessiveness, care, and concern. And I am seeing that if you are a parent, you might be more into your children, you might be more possessive about your children, and you might not let them live their life according to them. You will be more indulged into your children and your family life this year. And if you are thinking of controlling something like very desperately, you need to calm yourself down, you need to calm your anger down and then handle things a little bit maturely. You need to be practical this year. You need to maintain trust and build up better relationship with your parents, with your children and with your family. If you are looking for some new opportunities, I don't think so that opportunities might come for you this year. You might have to work for the opportunities. And also I am seeing if you are planning on moving to foreign countries, there is a possibility of that as well, but not in the first half. It is possible in the second half. Also, I am seeing that emotionally you will be more indulged and you will be less practical this year. So you need to balance that yourself. Moving on to the next zodiac sign, that is Sagittarius. As we all know that Sagittarians already think a lot and they hold on to things. This year, there is going to be a lot of thinking, a lot of overthinking, a lot of anxiety, and they will be holding on to a lot of things from the past. And if something happens, little bit emotional for them, it is going to be a little bit up and down for them again. And this year is not good for them according to the relationship part. If they are thinking of giving commitment to somebody, they might have to think twice. Do not take impulsive decision. I am seeing a pattern that you guys will be more into impulsive decision making and impulsive actions. Sagittarians out there are thinking of getting commitment or giving commitment to somebody, you might have to think twice. If you are taking things a little bit slowly, you might have to buckle up because this year is going to be full of enthusiasm and motivation. You might have to put efforts and then you will get results as well. As this year is the year of Venus, you might expect financial increments as well. do not get more indulged into casual relationships or casual hookups. This year is going to be the year of commitment, but think twice about it, because I am seeing a little bit of a pattern that you will not be very much happy with the people that you are getting this year or interacting with this year. As I told you that you don't need to hold on to the things, because this might make you a little bit anxious and it might have an effect on your work life. You will have to look into a different direction, or you might have to change your perspective on looking onto the things to make things work for yourself. Now is the turn for the next zodiac sign, that is Capricorn. If you are expecting something new in your life, this is not the year for you to accept new opportunities or move on to something new in your life. Second thing, this year is going to be a little bit of a confusing year for you. You might not be able to step onto the conclusion in the first go. Third thing that I am seeing over here is you will put a lot more efforts this year, but you will not get the results that you have always desired for, or the efforts that you have put already, you will not get the results for that either. So do not lose your hope. Do not lose whatever is motivating you. Just keep on working for it. By the end of year, you will get the results for whatever you have been working for. Stay out of arguments. Stay out of fights. This year might be the year of fights and arguments for you. If you have never been attached to your family, I think this year you will get more attached to your family. And if you have never listened to their opinions, I think this year you might have to do that, because that will be good for your finances and your career. So if you are thinking of making some new changes, it is the year to slow down on that thing. But if you are thinking of making some minor changes, you can take the suggestion from your parents and move forward with that. Moving on to the next sign, that is Aquarius. How is 2022 going to be for all the Aquarians out there? If you are thinking of giving commitment to anybody, I think you need to hold on to that, because this year is not going to be the year of marriage or commitment for you. If you are thinking of making some new changes in your work field, I can see that you can go for it and it is going to be good for you. Do not take any impulsive decisions regarding your personal or professional life. Think twice and then move forward with anything. Do not hold on. Do not control things that are not in your control. Just go with the flow. Things might work for you and things might not work for you. It is going to be an up and down year for you. You cannot expect all the abundance coming your way this year. This is going to be a good year for you financially as well as emotionally, but you cannot expect everything out of this year. Also, if you have never been more connected to your family, I think that this year is going to be more connected to the family part. And also, if you are already married, you might also develop a connection with your partner. If you are expecting financial abundance, you can expect that in the last quarter of the 2022. So if you want to make any changes, hold on to that. If you want to just go with the flow, go for it. It's a yes. Talking about the last zodiac sign, that is Pisces. How is 2022 going to be for all the Pisceans out there? This year is going to be very good for all the Pisceans, as I am seeing a lot of happy news coming for them. I am seeing financial abundance coming for them. I am seeing that they might even get to travel to foreign countries. And I am seeing that there will be more stability career-wise. They might just have to take care of one thing, that they do not give up if the situation is tough at any point. They might even have to juggle around sometimes in the decision-making, because there will be options in front of them a lot of times in this year. But overall, this year is going to be very good. I am seeing that if you are single and if you have been looking for a good partner, you might even find somebody suitable for you. And if it is regarding your married life, I think you will be more connected to your partner this year. If you have made it to this point, I will thank you from the bottom of my heart, because this video is quite long. And I would request you to like, share, subscribe to my YouTube channel and show some love. Thank you.